This the part people don't like.
Are you not entertained?
I'm about to get ready to lay down some painter's tape since you're going to be drilling up in here. You want to lay some painter's tape down for you won't chip, crack your paint, and then splinter it out or something. Because you're going to be drilling into it right here. About to tape this up, make the measurements. I'm going to replicate the same thing over there on that side. But I'm going to show this side just for everybody can see it.
Make the measurements to put where I want mine. You can put yours anywhere, really. It's honestly depends. It's such a custom option. You can put it wherever you want. I'm about to measure it up, put mine where I want mine. These be the parts most car owners don't want to see. The fresh dip paint been drilled into. It's definitely something you should do before you get it painted. Laying it down this far because I'll be using this to line some of this up. I want enough paint protected as possible. And I want to be able to write on it. I'm going to follow this. Gotta take all the precautions of the camera. What are we gonna do with this one? Play it safe. Play it safe. Alright, I'm about to measure this up. I'll be back. What's up? Back. That's my pull up costume for a minute. So I can measure this out. See where I'm gonna go. Grab me a pen.
Okay, for mine, this
come down this edge. I come down 9 inches. I come in, this is 6 inches wide. So I come in 3 inches. Get an even mark right here. This is where I'll be drilling my hole. You got the single tong antenna, this would be the only hole you drill. You got the kind like I got, let me grab it. Got it measured out. My L ruler coming down, riding this line. I'm coming down 9 inches. That's where the first hole will be at. Coming down 9, bringing it in 3 to even this out. This is 6 inches. So even it out at 3. If you wanted it lower down on the fender, of course you would come down here. I like mine up in about the 9-inch area. We go back, you know, it'd be coming out this way. So from this body line, that 9 down, 3 in. And then mine has this double on it. So from that hole, I'll be laying that down and measuring that too. Put that hole in. But first, let's make the big cut. This the cut don't nobody like seeing when they get the Impala gun. You grab my drill, my bit, let's go. So, that's a nice drill bit right here. We're gonna go 7/8. Bit focus in. 7/8. Drill bit. That way it just go in slower and slower and slower. Open it up more and more. But you're gonna go to full 7/8. This the part people don't like. This part people don't like to see. Let me get this done to their car. But it's a necessary evil. So a lot of people like to get it done, you know, before their car get painted. But since this is not the situation, this is what has to be done. So remember, we're going 9 in, 9 down, 3 in, making our first hole. We're going the whole 7/8. So here we go. Let's make a little soft hole at first. And let the drill bit do all the work. Don't push down and all that. Just when you initially get it, then let the drill do all the work. Shavings out the way. That's the part people don't like to see, but it's part of the game. Now that you got the 7/8 hole in, this one drill bit, gotta go a little bit bigger. So just the part people hate. Gotta make it just a little bit bigger. Cause it gotta have a little tilt on it. So we're gonna go from 7/8 all the way down to 1 inch. If you can find one with just straight 1 inch on it, grab that, one straight shot. On one-inch hole. Stutter this where the next hole gotta be. Now we're about to drill that out. The parts people hate to see. Check the fit. Open it up just a little bit more. Yep, we good. So the second hole, I went on and opened it up to a quarter of an inch. So this is 1 inch, quarter of an inch. So now we got the holes done. Take the tape off real quick. Take these little slippers off. But one thing I do like to do when I do mine, so I'll go over it with tape one more time. Go over the holes. And from the inside, just hit it with a little spray paint. Just to hit them open circles. That's raw now. Just hit it with a little bit of spray paint. This is back when trunks was trunks. Air blow everything out the way. But when you mess with metal shavings or rubbing into it. So now just peel the paint off. She had laid down. Make sure you use painter's tape so you ain't got nothing to worry about. When it comes to your paint. Take a little piece of tape and get the little straggle pieces hanging around. So, bring y'all along because y'all can see this.
So once you're done, you should have two nice clean holes. Remember, the first big hole is a 1-inch hole. The one next to it is a 1/4-inch hole. From this lip, use the edge ruler. Bring it down 9 inches, 3 inches in. 3 inches in. So, set y'all back up right here. Look at our components of the antenna. You got the actual antenna, you got a rubber gasket, you got this that levels it out flat inside the trunk. When you lay it in there, of course, you got your chrome piece, antenna screws into the top. Our antenna has this small little, let's see if it focuses in on it. Got this small little stud that screws into the antenna. Guide this screws in. Just keep screwing until you hit the bottom of it. And there you go. Let's see. Bring y'all along. So now you got one antenna on. Don't forget, come over, go 9 inches down, 3 inches in, 1-inch hole. Measure that up with this. You might not have the double screw. This one just happened to have the screw on it. So if you got the screw, 1/4-inch hole, once you line it up, remember, put the gasket on, run the piece through, put this brace on with the nut and your antenna. Repeat the same thing on the other side, and you got dual antennas. Or one antenna if you just want to want one. And you can also run the wire to it, like I said, if you want it to really work. Mine is just a quick decoration. Both of the antennas on. Seen this one already. Other antennas on. Like I said, this was like a custom option, so you can put them anywhere you want. I just like mine at the 9 and the 3. But like on this side, I had to, like I said, my antennas are decoration, so I'm not using them. So I had to cut the antenna because this bar was hitting. So I had to cut that, chop it. As you can see right here, if you want to run your real antenna, you could. That's what that's for. But that's it. Dual antennas installed. That's it. Now, the antennas gotta go to powder coating.